Hey everybody, welcome to another edition of Happy Hour Showcase. I'm your host for this week, Community Manager Jared Huckaby. Now, if you've never seen the Happy Hour Show, it's where we take some time out of our day at the end of the week on a Friday and spend that with you, with the Star Citizen, the Star Citizen, quite frankly. joining me today, we have our other community manager, our brand new community manager here joining us here in the LA studio. Why don't you introduce yourself, Tyler?
Hi, everyone. I'm Tyler Nolin.
You got more than that?
No, I'm just Tyler Nolin. I'm very not interesting at all.
This is your first show, man. We need more than that.
I'm glad to be here.
You're glad to be here? Okay. We're off to a rocking start
yes.
So far. Also joining us from the dev team is QA tester, Mr. Andrew Hernando. How you doing, Andrew?
I'm doing good. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. We finally got the show started. We had a few technical difficulties at the beginning, but, you know, we got them squared away. And joining us from the community, community Twitch streamer, Mr. Grittspitter. How you doing, man?
Good. Glad to be here. Thanks for having me.
Good. Now, you are a streamer on Twitch. You know, we have folks that stream on Twitch. We have folks that stream on Beam. We have folks that stream on YouTube. Why don't you tell the folks at home a little bit about yourself and what you do?
Well, I am an aging mid-30s lifelong PC video gamer. I stream over at twitch.tv/Grittspitter, just like it's spelled, double T, double T. And main focus is obviously Star Citizen. Most of it is about, I've been a backer for 4 years-ish, I guess now. Mm-hmm. And most of what I do there is just trying to help, well, old backers and new prospective backers get their head around the scope and size of the game, answer questions, just because I've been nerding out on the development for 4 years. So I've got a lot of information rattling around in my head, and I try to be kind of realistic and keep things in perspective.
Well, we certainly
get too crazy.
We certainly appreciate it. What'd you think of yesterday's ATV?
What was that? I missed that.
I said, sorry. What'd you think about yesterday's ATV?
Yesterday's ATV was excellent. The last handful have been absolutely fantastic. There was so much good info in yesterday's ATV.
Would you be saying that if I weren't sitting here right now?
I would.
Okay. All right. So on Happy Hour, if you've watched Happy Hour before, you notice we have a couple different rotating formats. We do a Happy Hour game dev, where we have a developer here at CIG take us through the steps in creating an asset or a game system for Star Citizen. We'll be returning to that in the coming weeks. We have the Happy Hour Museum, where we investigate the history of a game that's in Star Citizen's DNA, be it something developed by Chris Roberts, Aaron Roberts, Tony Zurabek, or something else. Then we have the Happy Hour interview, which if you watched last week, you saw, where we had Sean Tracy and Steve Bender and Jake Ross sit in with Ben Lesnick and answer your questions live from the chat. And then, of course, our fourth show in the rotation is the Happy Hour Showcase, which is what you're seeing today. That's where we just sit back and we showcase one of the game systems that are currently available inside Star Citizen. So with that, because Grittspitter is our guest and because Grittspitter has spent quite a lot of time climbing the leaderboards in Star Marine.
Oh, gosh.
As I checked, I was a little surprised to see how well you were doing in Star mm-hmm. Marine. We're going to put those skills to the test and see if you can carry our intrepid CIG staff here.
I'm very heavy.
To victory. So so as you see, we've got a game all queued up here. We got Grittspitter, we got Tyler, we've got Andrew's Wolfenstein, and we have our very own JJ LeBret. JJ, you on mics?
Oh, hey.
How you doing, JJ?
Pretty good. How about you?
I'm doing well. JJ is our cinematographer, videographer here at the studio. He's the one who actually runs the tech boards and everything for our broadcasts, so I can sit here and read your questions and chat. So
I could mute you too, but
you could.
I won't do that.
You could. You have.
I have.
You have. In
it's been a while.
Yeah. So what level are we playing right now?
We are on Station Damien.
Station Damien.
And we're doing Elimination.
Right. Now, between the two Ooh. Stations in Star Marine, is that the larger one or the smaller one?
It's the smaller one.
Damien is the Echo Station. Is
Echo 11's
Echo 11's
one.
The
that's
right.
Oh, to me, wow. Great to each other. Woo!
You're not living up to those leaderboards, are you, Greg?
Yeah, now this is Elimination. You're not playing Team Elimination, are you? You're just playing...
No, Elimination is a free-for-all.
Yeah, you're just playing free-for-all, so...
Deathmatch action.
So you're all playing against each other, as well
yes.
as other members of the Star Citizen community. Why don't you bring up your scoreboard so I can see how many people we got going in here. We've got, what, 8 people in here now?
Nice.
And of course, this game is available to all, guys. So if you do want to jump in the game and take your shot at killing a couple CIG developers, you can join a Station Damien elimination game. It's on our public servers in the U.S. region. So you will have to join in the U.S. region. So we are going to be taking some questions here and there from our Twitch chat. So if you're watching the broadcast, you can join into the Twitch chat.
Yes.
And of course, you can help me out by prefacing your question with the word question in capital letters surrounded by brackets. It just makes it easier for me to pull it out from the numerous
Grit
chats is there.
That was payback, JJ.
Now, Grit, I don't want you to hold anything back, Grit. I brought you on today because I saw you standing on the leaderboards here.
I actually haven't checked that. Where am I on the leaderboards?
I actually can't look at the moment.
That's all good.
Somewhere.
We have Captain Richard in the chat. How you doing, Captain Richard? Captain Richard Someone is another Star Citizen community streamer on Twitch.
I'm bleeding.
Don't lose that ace.
So Grittspitter's already an ace.
The ace.
Now, I have never been an ace. Would you believe that, chat? Though. If you've watched previous episodes of the Happy Hour Showcase, you might find it very easy to believe that I've never been an ace.
Pretty believable.
Commander Hermit Boy has a question. He says, Delta Patcher update. Delta patching, if for those of you who may not be familiar, is the process in which our game patcher would only feed to you the select files that have been updated instead of downloading all the files necessary for each individual game patch. That's something we're extremely anxious to have.
Yeah.
Guarantee, we want it as much as you want it. It's in process. There's no ETA at the moment. But the guys are working very hard on it. We have to build our own Delta Patcher from scratch. It's not one of those things that we can just take from somebody else, unfortunately. So, but it is coming. It is in active development over in our awesome studio. And I know everybody over there is as anxious to get it out to you as you guys are to have it.
Hey, guys, the four of us are topping the leaderboard.
Are we?
Tyler just got killed by Stilinski?
Stilinski.
Stilinski?
Stilinski.
Good job, Stilinski.
Yes, good job, Stilinski.
So, Tyler... You are relatively new to the community team. You've been on the community team for what, 2 weeks, 3 weeks?
About that time, yeah.
About that time. What were you doing before that?
I was in QA in Austin, Texas.
You were in QA in Austin, Texas. So how'd you like that experience?
It was a lot of fun.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was great. You do a wide range of things and kind of get to pick and choose a little bit what you like, and you know, if there's something that you can specialize in, that's even better. So it was really a great experience in learning and starting with game development.
Yeah, it's very common in game development, not just for Star Citizen, but for all over, for many designers, developers, you know, from all walks of life, to start their careers in QA.
Yeah,
because QA is a great way to learn the fundamentals of game development.
Oh, so close, man. So close.
And Andrew, you are currently in QA here in the LA studio, correct?
Yes, I am.
When did you start? You started, what, 4 months ago?
November,
5 months ago?
Yeah. Right before the...
Right before the anniversary live stream?
Yes.
I remember, were you a member, were you on Team Anvil or Team Aegis? During the... can't remember.
Team USA, actually.
Oh, for the other live stream.
Oh!
Yes, the other live stream.
Broke War says, question... Ships in 262. Yes, we will have spaceships
in
Alpha 262. We are not removing the spaceships in our upcoming patch.
Spaceships?
That's a really good idea, actually. Star Citizen would be fantastic with spaceships in it.
S. Monager says, would you rather be a Jedi or a wizard in the Harry Potter universe? What?
Wait, so be a Jedi in the Harry Potter universe or be a wizard?
I think what he's asking is, would you rather be a Star Wars Jedi or would you rather be a Harry Potter wizard? It's a question from our audience.
I think I would have to choose Jedi.
Andrew?
Jedi.
Grit?
I have to go with Jedi.
I'm going to go with Jedi.
JJ?
Jedi.
I'm going to have to go with a Lando. I'd rather be a Lando.
Fairly similar force and magic, except one gets to use a lightsaber and the other one gets a stick.
Yeah, so that's not even a... I would be afraid of anybody who would choose a wizard in that situation. And I like Harry Potter, don't get me wrong.
I do too.
But Greendraw TV says, question, newsletter today? Yes, every Friday. Usually comes out in the afternoon Pacific time.
Anything special in the newsletter?
Oh, gosh.
Can you tell us?
I'm not going to give you a preview of the newsletter. The newsletter is always a pretty good source of information. The newsletter might be slightly delayed today just because we have some broadcast problems with our YouTube. We normally simulcast Happy Hour on YouTube and Twitch. That was what delayed the beginning of our show today. The YouTube stream would not initialize. So we'll have to take care of that after the broadcast ends. So that might delay the newsletter a little bit, but the newsletter will come out today.
It just needs a good kicking.
Yeah, like all things.
Just smack the box.
Great. So somebody show me a scoreboard. Let me see it.
I'm killing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Grittspitter, Wolfenstein, Andrew Hernando. Oh,
I've dropped.
I think Andrew dropped you.
Somebody's sneaking Andrew. Up on me.
Grittspitter here with his face bullets delivery service. Hey, 1042, would you like some face bullets? Let's see what else we got here.
They're bullets of love.
Sir Price says, super important question, so I absolutely have to read this.
Oh.
Super important question.
Shut down. Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. What am I pressing?
Are you going to add space sharks? No. I honestly don't know. I can tell you there's absolutely no plan to add space sharks at this time. But of course,
isn't the future isn't the priority space whales first?
No. The future is an unwritten tapestry. Who knows what it may hold? But at present, no plans for space sharks.
Oh, if there are space sharks, nope.
Yep.
I have a planet.
Nikolai von Imhoff says, Disco, if you could be as good as these guys in Star Marine, which blood magic would you use? I don't even understand the question.
What?
Oh, he's asking which blood magic would I use to become as good as these guys in Star Marine? I don't think such a magic exists. That's far too powerful. That's far too powerful a thing to exist in this world.
It would require the sacrifice of a space shark.
Yeah.
Yes. What about little mini space sharks for the fish tanks? Ideas.
Well, we have talked to character art director Josh Herman about what he wants to do for the next game dev that he's on. He won't be on the next game dev that we do, but hopefully we'll have him back on the one after that. And I think tentatively we were discussing developing something for the fish tank. So we'll see. That's nothing written in stone, guys. That's just what we've been talking about. So we will, of course, put it up to a vote like we did with the last one. The last vote where you guys voted us a flying spider.
Yes.
Which was terrifying.
With nine legs.
Flying spider with
crotch
nine
spider.
Legs.
Crotch spider?
Ugh. No, they did not vote the crotch spider. That just happened on its own. That just happened on its own. But yeah, we will put up a thread when we approach that time. And you guys will vote on what type of creature we create. We are actually looking for the next game dev. We're actually looking at a bit of visual scripting. It'll be more bug smashers than it will be character creation, but it should be interesting.
Nice.
Should be fun. Let's see, what else do we got here? Kendar, who I can. I'm sorry, I don't even know why I try reading names. I always end up embarrassing myself. Do you think that the way that the engine is developed, that it might be possible to do Mobile Suits Gundam in a total conversion mod?
Did not see that.
CryEngine/Yumberyard is incredibly versatile. I don't see why if you have the proper skills, time, and motive to do so. I don't see why you couldn't mod something like that. We're not going to do it, but. I believe your question is, would it be possible
Tyler.
For you to do?
Yes, dear.
God. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Jared did say Yumberyard.
Yumberyard.
I heard that.
Yumberlard.
Did I say Yumberyard?
He said Yumberyard.
Who just became ace?
That's my third ace status of the round.
Oh, my goodness.
Go Ganina?
Show me that score screen, Grit.
Go Ganina?
Oh, my gosh. You're just running away with it.
Oh,
holy cow.
Print screen.
Holy crap.
Give me a run for my money.
Yeah, let's give a good shout out to Tactical Wizard and Gojina.
Gojina.
So Tactical Wizard and Gojina. Congratulations on breaking the top five. Everybody breaks the top five except Tyler.
Whoops.
But you still acquitted yourself way better than I ever did. So do you want to do another elimination or you want to try some team based?
Let's do some Last Stand. I think it will be a lot of fun.
All right. Mix it up.
So they're going to set up for a Last Stand match here. We'll actually get to play on the same team. Neo Onyx asks, did Chris approve the spider to be put in the game? It has not actually been through that process yet. there are a lot of things that go through, you know, between the different pipelines. A lot of things are submitted between the various pipelines. And for fauna, fauna is the animals.
Yes.
Flora is the, for fauna mm-hmm. and stuff, not there yet. So it's there in a pile with other stuff, and other stuff that are being created. So it remains to be seen whether our flying crotch spider will make it to game. But it will be submitted along the same pipeline as everything else.
Well, first we need to develop planet Nope.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. We have to convince Luke Presley, designer for the Precision Universe, to let us add Planet Nope.
Planet Nope.
Maybe not Planet Nope, but maybe
Planet of the Nopes.
Yeah, maybe just Nope asteroid or something.
It could replace all of the things we would say Nope to.
I think there should be a regrets system that nice. Contains Planet Nope.
Well, I could design that system in minutes.
Round 3 of 4.
All right. So this is last stand. This is team versus team. You guys are what, on the Outlaws?
We are Outlaws, yes.
You guys are on the Outlaws, and you currently have a 4-cap. Why do you already have a 4-cap?
It looks like we've joined a current match.
Wait, did four of you log into a 4-cap?
Man, we're doing so good. Oh, we look at that. We won. Yeah.
Easiest game
wow,
I've ever played.
So good.
Good job, guys. Good game.
Thanks for the carry, Grit.
Nice.
So of course, Grit is the only one that got a kill.
Yes. Out of us.
Yeah.
That'll teach him to try and roust us.
I wish
that will teach him.
That was the end then, too.
Oh, that was the end. Yeah. So you guys need to drop out and start a new match then.
Good game, everybody. It was intense.
It's just going to roll into another series.
GG.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll just start a new one after this.
So. Yeah, so we got into a match and steamrolled for... You won 3 rounds instantaneously.
We're very good.
Okay. Let's see, what else we got? Nipes Games says, will our characters' mouths move when we speak on voice chat in-game? That would be very cool. I don't know whether that's going to be a reality or not, just because that system hasn't been developed yet. So it's one of those things when you jump into developing a particular game system, you always have all these great intentions. You want to do as much as you can. Of course, it all depends on the resources and the time and everything else that's necessary within the game. You know, because you can make a great system where your lips work with the voice chat, but that system has to work with all the other facial animations and every other game system in the game. So it definitely sounds like a very cool idea, and from what I know about Chris, something he would definitely be, he would definitely think would be cool. But I couldn't tell you whether that's going to be the case or not, because we're just not there yet, unfortunately. What else do we got?
I got you back, Tyler.
Oh, I did not see where that shot.
Thank you very much.
Which means you're probably going to die soon.
No!
Motel says, at which point will orgs be customizable in-game? Will I be allowed to subdivide my org into multiple branches with their own budget? We were just talking with Benoit and our friends at Turbulent about upcoming changes to the org system this week. There's a couple different ideas in mind.
Yeah.
A couple different things they want to do. They want to be able to let you customize the roles, because right now, you know, since the org system has been introduced about 3 years ago, the roles have not been customized. We want to be able to let you customize not just the ranks, but the roles, so that you can build the organization around a structure that you want. And then once that is working on the website and within Spectrum the way that we want it, then I can see it being implemented into the game, because there's really no reason to do it into the game until we have it on the website exactly how you want.
Grenade.
So the answer is someday. I couldn't tell you when though.
Yeah, I mean it'll give players kind of better control to manage the organization, and you know that obviously will carry over into Spectrum too. So
it's definitely something on the books. It's just like all things in game development priorities.
Ah, revenge kill.
Because that would be linked in game eventually too. Right?
Yes.
The organization control and Spectrum.
Yes.
Oops.
Yeah. It all kind of goes hand in hand. Makes sense.
You're going to find guys that when questions are generally the hardest and most impossible to answer, because we are still in the middle of our game development. So
I have a question that's not a win question.
Sure.
Do you like pineapple on your pizza?
Gosh.
Are you really bringing this back?
What is
seriously?
This with you with pineapple on the pizza?
It's not me. It's community.
No. Nobody's ever asked me about pineapple on a pizza except you.
So what is it then?
I do enjoy
What is it? It's damage that you have in your head is what it is.
I that's probably true.
First of all, you should never put pineapple on pizza.
Head full of pineapple?
Eggplants.
Accessing control point. Oh my gosh, they're all over it.
262 to the PU. Our guys are working very diligently on getting to 262 to the PU. As you saw, as you may have seen in last week's production schedule report, our intention was to push 262 out to the Ibokati this week. We are still working on that, chasing down those final blockers. But again, it's another thing that's just really hard to anticipate, because you can't. How do you predict how long it's going to take to fix fix an issue? Okay, so, but trust me, as soon as it can go out, it'll go out to the Ibokati, because it's another one of those things where we're as anxious to have it out to you guys as you guys are to have it.
Aren't you supposed to be carrying us right now?
I am not doing well at all.
Yeah, well, that's the big difference between Last Stand and Elimination. Elimination is all about just running around killing people, but Last Stand requires a lot more strategy. And you don't win Last Stands by killing people.
No.
You just don't.
No, you gotta hack. You gotta hack.
That's why I do much better at Last Stand than I do Elimination.
I actually prefer tactical gameplay a lot more. I can't wait for stamina to come in and all the gadgets. That's going to be a big game changer.
Question from Eat Me Maybe says, can the Reclaimer salvage ship with alive people in it?
Yes.
Grinding them to meat.
Oh.
I don't know, but I expect that. I expect you'll be the first person to try it and let us know.
Human
when
salvage.
That time comes.
Emergent gameplay.
Well, we just build the game systems. What you guys do with it? We are constantly impressed by the things that you guys do that we never anticipate with the game systems, and that's one of the best things about sandbox development. We just build the game systems, put them together, and then we see the things that you guys do with it.
Absolutely.
So I can't tell you whether it's going to be possible. I expect you to tell me whether it is possible when that time comes.
Respawning. Now I kind of want to try.
Oh, I bled out. I was trying to defend C. Not going to happen.
Make it count. Control point contested. Don't let them take the control point. Looks like meat's back on the menu, boys.
Control point locked. I recognize the quote, but I don't recognize where it's from.
We better not lose another one.
You don't know where it's from?
I can't remember it right now.
Are you kidding me?
I'm in the middle of doing a lot of things right now.
JJ, where's it from?
What's it from?
Lord of the Rings, man.
Oh, I knew the accent. I knew it was the Cockney.
Okay.
The Cockney orc or goblin or whatever the heck it was.
Oh no, my gun won't stop shooting.
Meat popsicle.
Neonix says, with Lumberyard in play, are private servers still going to be a thing? Lumberyard would have nothing to do with that, but private servers is a thing that we don't even think about or look into until after the main game is developed. I just don't have an answer for you now. It's just way too soon.
That was that. Am I correct? I can't remember. It's been a while, but was that part of a stretch goal way back in the day?
Not stretch goal, but it was part of the original crowdfunding campaign that we would offer
servers
and stuff like that. So, but it's still not a thing that you don't work on that concurrently. You're trying to build the MMO. You build the MMO. You build it, and then you figure out how to make private servers out of it. So we're just a long ways away from having an answer for that, unfortunately.
A post-release feature.
Yep. Do, do, do.
Trying to stick with you, CIG boys.
That's probably a bad idea.
I don't think we'll fit in your backpack.
We are very easily targeted.
So,
Sorry,
I missed it. Who won round one?
We did not win round one.
Outlaws won round one.
You're the Marines this time, huh? What are you doing, Grit?
Got him.
Did I do
grenading
something?
The guy upstairs.
Oh, I did something.
I just saw you. It looked like you were dancing by yourself. Vila 4480 says, with VR harder and harder to implement with new UIs, is it still in the post-release plans at all? Thanks. Vila, if you go to our forums, the older forums, not the new Spectrum ones, Will Maiden has some posts regarding that topic right now. And instead of trying to paraphrase what he said and probably messing it up, I'm just going to direct you to those posts. But he did comment about VR and the work being done on VR recently. So if you can use the dev tracker on the old forums, you can see the post from Will Maiden.
Am I gonna get it? I got it. But I am bleeding.
Did we do a thing?
We did a thing.
I am getting wrecked.
So exciting.
Right. I'm bleeding.
So here's a question for Tyler 2.0. I'm guessing that's you.
That's probably me.
Oh. Is that the better version?
What is your... It would seem to imply...
An upgraded version. To imply.
What is your plan for the game? What will you fly? What kind of occupation will you pursue?
Well, I have a favorite ship. That's the Merchantman. And I think I will probably be a smuggler. I think that's what I've liked playing a lot and do the mercantile kind of profession, but something a little bit more on the grayscale of things.
God, scared me.
How about you, Grit?
I'm looking forward to mostly doing exploration, kind of a handful of different things. Really excited to basically play Scotty and run around repairing a ship. I also really want to create an alt character. I have this whole thing I want to do with being a space hobo. And basically create an alt character that never touches a ship. The first time I load in, I'll just thumb a ride and see where he ends up in the verse.
That's kind of cool. A hitchhiker.
How about you, Andrew?
Yeah, exactly.
I have no idea yet. Control point. I haven't really decided. I'm a very indecisive person when it comes to these kinds of things.
Darken. Good job, Andrew.
Good job.
How about you, JJ?
I want to be a pirate.
A pirate.
Pirate. I just want to board people's ships, take their things. You know, that guy.
I've been thinking about this actually for a while, actually, and I think the thing that I would like to do, the thing that I would like to do in the game would be different if I didn't work here than it would be if I did work here. But as I do work here, the thing that I think I'm going to do in the Persistent Universe is I would like to fly a Genesis Starliner.
Ooh.
For like, you know, Meridian Transit. Like when your ship blows up and you spawn back at Ryla or something, but your hangar with all your ships are back on Terra, so you need to take public transit. I think it would be hilarious to pick up people as public transit and then fly them around and then like, hey guys, this is Disco Lando, and we're like, it's like, what? Like, yeah, just run public transit in the universe. I think it would be amusing.
Are you going to be an Uber driver?
I think it would be amusing if players got into a taxi or shuttle and flipping Disco Lando was there driving it. Like, what are you doing? I'm like, yeah, I'm just driving. I'm just shuttling people from left to right.
Disco's space Uber.
Yeah.
Would there be cool party lights inside and like bumping music?
Maybe.
Maybe.
Oh man. Oh, Saurus is in here. Correct me in the face.
Nipes Game says, do we get to make a second account on our game package, or do we need to make an SE account for another character to play? Nipes, that is something that's still being worked out. There's been a plan in place where for every game package you own, it allows you a character slot. That's been the intention for some time, but because we're not there yet, where we have to actually build that system in place, it's one of those things where we're still keeping our options open and still evaluating what might be the best course of action. So fortunately, I'm not going to have an answer for you about that until it comes time to actually start designing and implementing that system. It's one of the big misconceptions about video game development, that you have all the answers ahead of time. That would be video game construction, unfortunately. Development is the process of figuring all those answers out. So how you guys doing now?
We are winning.
We're currently winning.
We're doing a little better.
Don't jinx it.
A little better. You're splitting the points 2-2.
It's very close.
You got 90 seconds left, though.
I'm doing terrible, guys.
Hey, someone bring up
finding
a score
my
screen.
Groove.
Show me how JJ is doing.
No, please don't.
Oh.
I'm doing so bad right now.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm taking B.
It's like the worst I've ever done in an FPS.
JJ LeBrit playing the Disco Lando Memorial.
I saw that.
Position. Although, actually, on a last stand, I would be much higher.
Nice work.
Hey, Nubafire, welcome to chat. Oh,
that med pack's not where it used to be. Make it happen. There it is.
We better not lose another one. Accessing
control point. What else, friends?
Sophie Girl says, hi, Grit.
Hey, Sophie. Long time no see. How are you doing?
Control point gained. Apple Crow 88 in chat.
Hello. Sophie's great.
round over. Oh, cool.
Oh, we won.
I got last.
1-1. Heck of
a fight. Good.
You're so surprised. Oh my god,
I'm
we won.
Surprised.
Okay, time to change tactics. We're moving to a different infiltration.
Time to change tactics. Moving to a different infiltration.
No, I want to hear your British accent.
I can't.
Please, for me.
Meats on the table.
The British soccer announcer.
Yes.
Hello, everyone. Nigel Thickness here for the 2942 Murray Cup Challenge. Our racers today are Tyler Nolin, Andrew Hernando, JJ LeBrit, and the ever-present Grittspitter. Of course, I am your own Nigel Thickness. I lost it.
It was pretty good for a while.
I can't do it on the flag. I gotta practice. Hey, Anchor 654, welcome back to the chat. Question, is there any plan to change the lonership of the Carrick to the Aquila? Maybe when the Aquila is actually flyable in the game. But it's not a decision that has to be made right now, unfortunately. So, no answer to give you on that at this time. But check back in when the Aquila is actually flyable in the game. That seems to make sense to me.
Control point contested.
Alexis says, welcome back, Nigel. Hi, Alexis.
Hello, Alexis.
Control point Charlie's lost.
Alexis CIG, or CIG Alexis is our very own Alexis Lesnick, who you may recognize from our subconscious segment in Citizens of the Stars every Monday. Alexis is our subscription manager. So all that cool flair and stuff that you get every month as a subscriber and stuff. She has a very important role in making all that stuff happen. Jump points, the vaults.
Are you guys lagging?
Yes, a little bit.
Don't let them take the control point.
Oh, they're about to three cap you.
Uh-oh.
We're taking C.
I am trying to take C.
We lost the control
there we
point.
Go. I got you catching it.
Nikolai says, "Hey, Grit, as a hitchhiker, will you carry a towel with you at all times?"
Of course, you gotta have a towel. I've got one in my hangar right now.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, what's going on?
Just waiting for me to step out into the verse.
Reebok took both of you out. You both have Reebok kill screens.
Yes.
Wow.
Reebok is doing really good shotgun. With 30 kills right now.
Good lord, really?
Every time I say Alexis, your Alexa goes nuts. Alexa, what's the weather like today? I'm triggering somebody's Alexa at home.
Alexa, play Who Let the Dogs Out?
Oh, God.
Yes.
Don't do that again.
I did it. Sorry.
Don't
I had
do
to.
That again.
I did it.
Alexa, Rickroll.
doing very well this round.
I'm getting a little desyncy on my end.
Alexis says that's why I can't own an Alexa. Alexis, they allow you to change the trigger word to computer now, like Star Trek.
Oh, that's cool.
So you can say computer. Hello, computer.
Oh, that's kind of well.
So if you did that, you'd be able to use it.
They have capped all four of the computer terminals.
That's terrible.
That's really, it's really bad.
Smash.
I was told I'd be carried today.
What should we go for?
The closest one, yes.
Alexa, what is the capital of every state in alphabetical order?
Control point gained.
I have an Alexa.
Can we add things to the grocery list?
Yes.
Well, have at it.
Alexa, buy red vines.
Respawning.
In bulk.
Okay. You got one.
We got one back. We got D. Which is the one closest to us.
Oh, we're doing great.
You were getting smashed.
Oh, we're not doing too great this time.
We're getting smashed.
Mm, that was rough.
I think they let us have the second round as an illusion. To make their victory that much sweeter.
Pretty brutal.
All right, Alexa says Twizzlers are greater than red vines. So let us know. Put a 1 in chat for Twizzlers, put a 2 in chat for red vines. Let's see which is better. Let's see if Alexa knows what we're talking about or not.
Protect the control point.
P
JJ is a noob.
Yeah, JJ is legitimately just did the cover to Oliver Stone's Platoon over there. He's like,
oh, I can't kill anyone.
I'll make everybody happy. Alexa, when will Star Citizen 3.0 come out?
Good to have you back in the fight.
Alexa doesn't take when questions.
No. All right. Come on, guys.
Teasing.
Oh, great. Yeah.
It's ready. Not that good this time.
Wow.
Can everybody tab out of that screen? Thank you.
She's pretty bad.
Put it away.
JJ, LeBrit. 8 kills, last 14 deaths.
I come around the corner, I see them for half a second, then they're on the other side.
Well,
of the
room. If it's any consolation, JJ, because you're so low on the screen, you're actually blocked by everybody's body.
Oh, thank God.
On the stream. So nobody can actually see that it's you at the very, very bottom.
This is really hard.
Very bottom.
Meat shield.
Let's see. Biomechanical says, hey, the Happy Hour team tonight. Hello to everybody in chat.
I died.
Did you die already? Was I not hitting? I don't think I was hitting.
It's grenades everywhere.
Grenades everywhere.
Biscuits from Uranus says, hey, when is the next concept sale?
Wait, what?
Don't have the exact time locked down just yet, but we are fast approaching. Keep an eye on the Spectrum forums. We have a thread where we announce the price of the upcoming concept sale. We try to do it at least a week in advance, although we don't always succeed, but we do try. So keep an eye on that. That's where the official announcement will be when the time comes. But if you checked out this week's Citizens of the Stars, you might have seen a lovely hint as to the nature of our next concept sale from the wonderful Sherry Heiberg, our archivist. She gave a wonderful hint as to the nature of our next concept sale. I'm not going to tell you here. Your fellow Twitch citizens can tell you in chat if you missed it.
I think it's going to be a ship.
That's a solid guess. That's a solid guess.
It's a safe answer.
Just theory crafting. Yeah.
Hey, underscore. Welcome to chat. Make it
happen. Underscore.
We're doing pretty well. Point contested.
Don't let them take the control point.
Ooh, I'm getting control point lost. Crazy leg.
Whoa!
Yeah, slug is bad.
Yeah, there's an existing bug for the fourth round of Last Stand, unfortunately.
Oh, what is going on?
You got another chance. Oh no, it's Rag, no rook. Count.
Is it? Wait, there's a person named Ragnarok in there?
I thought so. Maybe it was Revlock.
Close
enough. Can you check? Because I actually know a Ragnarok.
Revok?
No, it was Revok.
No, Revok, who's been killing you guys.
He's been very, very good at making me see the respawn screen. Over
yes,
over
yeah, there. I'm seeing Revok on all of your screens there.
Control point contested.
I'm having a.
Septiza says more love for medical / SAR. SAR meaning control search and rescue. Absolutely. Once the Cutlass rework is complete. Work will then proceed to the Cutlass Red and the Cutlass Blue. The Cutlass Red, of course, being specifically designed for search and rescue. Yeah. So that's the most immediate work that you're going to see on search and rescue. But of course, most certainly not the last.
Control point gained.
Well done, Marine.
Control point contested.
Scared to go get A on myself. Oh,
Protect the control point.
Control point lost.
Okay, this isn't working anymore. I'm gonna flip my laptop.
Are you dying still?
Yeah.
Let's check.
Oh, it's terrible.
Yes.
I can't even actually aim at anybody because they just like pop around.
I'm very much looking forward to the medical gadgets and stuff. I love playing medic in first-person shooters. I prefer playing medic.
I feel like Ravok is specifically just aiming for us.
Well, you'll be happy to know that your pain will be over in 3 minutes and 10 seconds. So, yes, this will actually be the last match of the broadcast, so.
Aw, that was so quick.
Yeah.
Oh, whoa.
Can't go out like this, guys.
Jared, has the community picked a name for our friendly spider?
There is a thread up on Spectrum where people can submit suggestions for our flying spider. that we saw in our first Happy Hour game dev. You can also vote, so don't forget to just, you know, don't just submit your answers or your suggestions, but don't forget to vote on the other ones that you like. You can vote for more than one. We will be announcing the name that we are. The way these things work, we're going to submit a couple of the names. We're going to take like our top five. It really depends on how close the thing is. If there's like six and then a huge dropout, we'll take those six. If there's four and then a huge drop off, we'll do four. But we'll take the top voted, you know, name suggestions, and we will submit that along with the concept.
Is there a Spidey McSpider face?
I can tell you that I will not be submitting a Spidey McSpider face.
Well,
a Spidey McSpider crotch.
Yeah,
maybe.
Okay.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
I was gonna say it will always be crotch spider to me.
Space crabs.
Big boy says, question. Hi.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hello.
Hey.
Howdy.
You there?
Stop it.
JJ, I'm gonna need you to try just a little harder.
I can't.
Just a little bit.
Nope.
Stimson says, from yesterday's ATB, we saw modular space stations that will be used to populate 99% of the stations. Will there be any non-human space stations, Vandal space stations maybe? Well, that would be telling.
Protect the control point.
Yeah.
Maybe?
I was curious about that.
It's a good question, but...
Or at least...
You'll have to wait and see.
Bravo points lost.
I was curious about that. If there would be design architecture for all the different alien races. I mean, they kind of have to be eventually, I would think.
Last minute.
I got B!
Can we do it? All right.
Well, we just got to hold these three.
We're getting there. Make it
happen. 45 seconds.
Somehow.
We could even take A. It would be even better.
Nice to have you back, Marine.
Hurry.
Oh.
Control point contested.
Oh, they're taking B.
Don't let them take B.
30 seconds
remaining.
I'm dead.
You guys actually, if you can keep B,
nope,
you actually can win.
We lost it.
You actually could have won that game if you had held on to B.
It's all JJ's fault.
Oh.
I'm kidding.
The lag is so bad.
JJ was not in last on our team this time.
Yeah, because the guy just joined.
All right. Well, with that completes our happy hour showcase for Friday, March 17th. It's St. Patrick's Day.
Yes, it is.
It's St. Patrick's Day.
Yes.
Are any of us wearing green?
No.
Oh, we're terrible.
Well, okay. In our defense, we have a giant green screen behind
us.
Yes. This would have been a very bad day to wear green.
Isn't it? I completely forgot.
So, thank you so much for taking the time to join us here for our happy hour showcase this week. Hey, Grittspitter, are you going to be streaming after the show?
I am. I'm going to immediately switch over to my channel.
All right.
Little more Star Marine.
All right. Why don't we give you a Star Citizen Squadron 42 combo package with a with an Anvil Hornet to give away on your
nice.
Stream?
Nice.
Ooh. Very so, nice.
So,
thank you.
So you can give that away. You can give that away at some point on your stream, and then send me the information for the winner. We'll get
you got
that awarded.
It.
So Grittspitter, anything you want to say before we let you go?
Can I plug a quick Bar Citizen?
Sure.
We're just in the initial planning stages for a DC area over in Virginia, Bar Citizen, tentatively April 29th. It's a Saturday. So if anybody's curious about that, stop by my stream and we'll get your contact info and I'll pass it off to the right people.
Yes, if you've never been to a Bar Citizen, I highly recommend it. They're always crowd organized. You know, it's not anything that we
It'll
get our
my
hands
first.
Into. They're always a great way to meet your fellow citizens and just chat, Star Citizen. So, Andrew, we're going to let you go. Go back to work. Go back to lunch, maybe, then. Go back to work.
Food.
I believe food is the correct term.
Food.
Food is the correct term.
You're not allowed to eat until Star Citizen is done.
All right.
Roommate lunch date.
It'll never get done.
Tyler, anything you want to say before we let you go?
I had a lot of fun, so, yeah, it was great.
Cool. All right, guys. So, for JJ, for Grittspitter, for Andrew Hernando, for Tyler Nolin, I'm Jared Huckaby. We'll see you next week, everybody.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Later.
Cheers.